Elvis immediately began a journey to regain control of his musical career. His first item of business was the songs themselves. Elvis knew he couldn't just retread his former rock and roll glory. Nonetheless, to find the sound of his future, he looked deep into his past.
Hiya, Roy, you all set to go? Okay, let's cut one.
His musical hero, seen here in a rare movie appearance, was Roy Hamilton.
My chickadee, come here to me.
An obscure R&B singer who greatly influenced Elvis's early vocal style.
Roy had a record called I'm Gonna Hold On Tight and Don't Let Go.
Well, I wouldn't stop for $1 million. I love you so. I just hold it tight and don't let go.
Hold on tight and don't let go. Elvis goes, that's gonna be the bottom part of my life. And Elvis just grabbed it, okay?
Who do you think of when you have such luck? I'm in love. Come on, shut up.
Hamilton had managed to extend his career by abandoning the youthful energy of his early R&B hits for a measured string of ballads aimed at a more mature audience. As he demonstrates here in the movie Let's Rock.
My father was an amazing balladeer. He had a great operatic and gospel type style. He had a big booming voice and it was like, I would call him the Black Caruso, you know, of music, rhythm and blues. The Black Caruso of rhythm and blues.
Walk on through the rain.
If Hamilton could do this, why not Elvis? So it was to the later Hamilton that the king looked for his own second coming. On the 10th of September 1967, Elvis booked into RCA Studio B in Nashville with his producer Felton Jarvis to record the Rodgers and Hammerstein ballad You'll Never Walk Alone, which had been a hit for Hamilton back in the 50s.
What I think Elvis took from my father is the big sound, the big voice, a strong vibrato. That gospel flavor, you know, being that Elvis was also a very spiritual person, he just kind of adapted that style and it worked.